about 1.05 on the prediction, which means about 0.95 on the 7th of July. I got a skinny boat. real championships starts here. Thank you. is the chicken chute. Can't see a lot of water in it. Chicken shoot it is. Kangaroo. Possible too low. Possible but too low. Those rocks at the top mean that the bottom is going to be another batch of rocks, of which I have no desire today. Actual Sid's Rapids. Missed the tree, missed the old arch. Thank you. It's big. Sleep fun today. Mushroom. guys. Yeah, they're your boats. It's a good day for it. Cheers. Thank you. one drop. Oh, really? Here we go. I'm gonna go over here, are ya? Eddie Pool, living up to its name. Thank you. Terminator. Silly way. here. It's a true meter. 1.0. 1 meter. Yeah. Yeah. Pretty big. I'll see you down there. I'll be a few minutes mucking around. There you go. Yeah. Not coming down there today. Ah. Look behind you, man. There's a couple of rocks there. It's easy this way, that way. You'd make a good video. Cheers, man. No, no, sorry. Come on. Water. beautiful river today. Look out. Just above Sids there, at Lookout Rapids. So about as well as 1 hour exactly from here, but so Sids, Championship Sids, Terminator and Bells, four big ones. So good, 1 meter exactly, so yeah, it's quite wild. And where have you paddled from today? I haven't? Oh, okay. Thought you were wet. Yeah, okay. 0.6, still good. Yeah. Was that 06, 08? Like about 10 years ago? Before that. Okay, yeah. I've done every race since 04, so there's been a couple of big ones. In fact, we had a big training, and then it came down for the race, didn't it? I think that year wasn't a big... that was a very, very low year. Yeah, or 1.4 or something. Yeah. We had a 0.4, and then we had a 0.2, and that was the lowest. Yeah, it's terrible, isn't it? So the first day is really the worst, though. Sorry? That's right, and it's not power. Like, if you're a novice or if you fall out, you're not going to get washed a K down the river, and there's much less chance of you getting pinned or drowned or any of these bad things. Well, most things are gone. That's exactly right. But at above about 1.5, 1.6, you don't shoot the chutes. And if you do, you're kind of silly. But in saying that, most of them are gone. Most of them are just... but sometimes it's like now I've got a huge wave in it and you will, you know, you've got a 50-50 big chance of something bad happening. Like SIDS, the approaches to SIDS become terrible, become huge, especially the first one, which is a bit of an S-bend. And, well, today there's a wave coming like this. And that's, you know, big but cool. You can just, you know, get ready for it. But if it's above, like I've come through there 2.5, 2.2, 1.9, and both waves, one coming this way because it's an angled chute there, it kind of... Oh yeah. No. This year we've had, so it was 4 meters last February when the rains came in February. It was 4 meters here, like 3.8 on the gauge, and up at Super Chute it was five and a half, six. You know, like it was. The biggest, highest in history in 2J. It was like half a metre higher than 60. It was January, wasn't it? Yeah. And then this year we had another one that was a metre in Feb. Not as high, but it was still big. I did Bells here at 3.5. The bottom of Bells. And I tried to get in on the side of the river there. And I thought I could paddle maybe across to the middle. But I hit the first of the water coming down. Woomph! I was down. And we paddled up, we got in at the bottom of the car park there, or the bottom of the road, which was the water's edge. And I paddled up here, and I got up in here, all the way up the car park, to the Devil's Slide there, to the halfway up, you know, just below the main chute. Paddling up, and I crossed the sides, and I went up the other side, halfway up, and you could do it, because the eddies were so great, the flow comes down and it has to get back, yeah, that's right. And as long as you stay in the trees on the sides, pulling up trees if you need to, I could get to, you know, maybe 100 metres from the bridge. And that was mental, because I then turn around and come down, and we did a lookout run at 2.6, 2.7, like a week after that, or 2 weeks after that, still very high, at the lookout. So most people jump the railway, and then just walk down to the river's edge and kind of put in at about where the main drop is. But what we do, which makes a lot more sense, and we kind of think, why don't you do this? You walk up the railroad for about 200 metres upstream. So you walk down the path from the top, you know, right by the edge of the fence. Yep. Well, it is a 20-minute hike down the hill. And if you've got a heavy boat, then what we do is we tie a rope, we tie our strap to the back, and I just slide the boat down with my gear, and it doesn't weigh anything, it's not doing any damage. So you slide down, and then, look out for my dad. Oh, there he is. And then you jump in, but what we do is, you walk upstream, and there's a drainage tunnel under the railroad, and you jump through the tunnel, which is about head high, it's quite high, and then you can pop out, and you've got a perfect put-in spot, just above, far enough above the main chute to shoot it. So it's above Lookout Rapids. Sorry, we're getting going? Yeah. Okay. Is Peter staying around or is he gone?
No, he's gone.
Oh, there
you
go. Oh, is he shooting it? Is he shooting Bells?
No.
Oh, okay, okay. He's never shot bells at a meter, I guess. It looks pretty scary when you haven't, like, when you don't know what it feels like, what it's like. But, I mean, a wave, you know, like, 0.6 is a wave like this. 1 meter is just a wave like this, and it's really not much more powerful. It might hit you in the head. You might lose your vision. You might have a, you know, whoosh for a bit, which throws you off. When it's above a meter, you reckon? Above 0.8. It does. I find it super hard to actually get into it. These guys think, oh, we just aim over there. But you can aim over there, and it can do a million things. Yeah, for me in this boat, it doesn't matter, because I can turn on it. Like, I got through today with 10 meters to spare, and I was still turning bad. Like, I turned bad. I came down, and I was, whoa, going left, and I was fine, you know? These guys in a double, or a skinny double, yeah, no, bugger that. You know, they got a 50-50 chance of having to turn left and doing a loop, and then... Yeah, that right-hand side of the chicken chute. Yeah. No. But today... Oh. Well, today, there's the two actual chutes there, though. You've got to be on the right-hand side of the two chutes, because there's a big rock in the middle that's out, and there's two chutes. The left-hand chute is not open. It's the chute, yay, what? No, you're talking about the left-hand side of the right-hand two chutes coming down. Well, there's a big rock there's a rock that's a meter out of the water right now, and you must be on the right-hand side of that, obviously. You'll see, yeah, but there's another chute that's, yeah, it's confusing anyway, but... But there's also trees below the chicken chute. You guys have smashed into the trees below the chicken chute many times as well. Ah, okay. Angle, yeah. Yeah. There's a haystack, the little approach chute. Everybody should be coming in on that far left-hand one, coming in on the S-bend, and then approaching the main chute at a diagonal across to the right, and then shooting it diagonally so that they can get out. But I come in the middle, which shoots you left, too much left, you know, so, but this, again, this boat doesn't matter, so, everyone watches me and then tries it, and they stuff up. the one where the traffic jam happens every year, that don't do this. There's three channels. There's main, left, right. Not a single soul knows that the right and the left exist, and they'll all go middle. And then above 0.6, 0.6 or 0.7, you can go, I think right opens first, and then left opens after that, but I always go left and right, and it's a fight with logs and trees, but you don't hit boats, so, you know, it's still like that every year. One guy will turn over, one ski will turn over, and then everyone will grab logs and say, stop, block the river,
stop, sorry.
Safety, and I yell out, it's a race, and you don't have a choice, yeah. It's a cutoff, and there's no danger, why are you stopping, you know? They think that every time a person falls in the water, it's a rescue situation. I mean, skis fall in the water a lot, ski paddlers fall in, you know. Yeah, I'll get out bottom there. I'll see you on the river, man. Good fun. Yeah.